Hey, what's up, you 4,000 beautiful people? Welcome back to the channel. As always, my name is Anton, and hopefully all of you guys are having a fantastic day because we're going to be checking out something brand new on the channel. This is 10 years in the song Wasteland, and this is a big shout to Sharon on the Patreon for requesting this one. And I've heard of these guys before. I don't think I've ever heard me actually listen to anything by them, though. I think my friend Victor liked them back in high school. And I think, you know what, you probably showed me a song, but I don't remember it at all. Because you'd always show me random stuff in the car and stuff. So, yeah, who knows. But before we get into this one, as always, if you guys have any song requests for me and you want to vote on what artists come on the channel every single week, join everybody in the Discord, link down below. And if you want guaranteed song requests, you want to check out all of our full album reactions, join everybody in the Patreon, link down below. And that's it. So let's get a 10 years, Wasteland. Sharon loves like the 2000s hard rock, so I know these guys are from that.
I attempt good intentions.
Interesting, launching right in just from the two lines. Man, that's such a 2000s thing. It's just like the what would you call it? Like just the. I don't even know what it is. It's like you're like riffing on the clean guitar or something. It just has this like rhythmic pulse, like driving sound. And usually you do that in the verse and then you add another layer in the second half of the verse or something. But it's like all 2000s hard rock has that. It's like, is it power chords? Is it just kind of like playing the top string on a power chord or something? I'm not sure, but like, I find it synonymous with like 2000s hard rock. It's just like, and I love it. I still can't get enough of it. It's just such a good way to drive a song forward while keeping it like vocally driven. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, right here, just.
You were not there, living in fear, but
interesting rhythmic tone to his voice.
I will not hide you through this. I want you to help and please.
Oh, he has a good voice.
The bleeding heart perched on my shirt. Die, withdraw, hiding cold sweat, quivering lips, ignore remorse.
Really cool vocal delivery. Yeah, where a lot of bands like in this genre, you got like Breaking Benjamin, Linkin Park, Shinedown, Skillet. Like these are hard rock bands that they are like their singers are in the forefront. They might have atmospheric music, but they always rely on the pure passion and power of their vocalists. Where interestingly enough, 10 years instrumentally seems like they would fit into all those categories. But the singer, he's more like subdued. He's more atmospheric. His voice almost like bleeds into the instrumental. He doesn't overtake anything like all of those other vocalists do. It's not like good or bad. It's just like an interesting observation about the differences that I'm picking up from some of the, from how 10 years differs from a lot of the bands in this kind of niche. You know what I mean?
Hopeless, the article read, living wasteland this time. You've tried all that you can, turning you red, but I will not hide you through this. I want you to
help. And even this, the way it's mixed is, he's doing that, but it's your background.
Your intentions, sure. good intentions. Wow. Limbs tight, skin tight, self-inflicted, his perdition.
That was a really interesting song structure, actually. That one was a bit different. Yeah, really cool. Really well mixed. Very well mixed. This singer has a really cool voice. Like I said, he fits the band so well. Very emotional. And yeah, it's actually really interesting that I'm listening to this music video now, because I just finished a 3-hour podcast with a guy who was... I think he was like an ex-jihadist. He was a terrorist. And he was in jail. He was tortured. I forget for how long, but he actually got broken out of jail by Amnesty International. And that's actually the time that he changed and he stopped being a jihadist. If I got the terminology right, I think jihadist is the right word. But yeah, he's like, yeah, I hated the West and everything the West standed for. And then it was only when I was thrown in jail by, I think, I forget what country he was thrown into jail for. In. And yeah, he said Amnesty International saved my life and said you should not be allowed to torture these people, because he technically was only tried and thrown into jail for his belief. He didn't actually do anything. And he's actually really, he's a good man. And now he's an incredible human being. He worked for the BBC for a couple of years. He had his own radio show there. I forget his name. But yeah, he was just talking about how easy it is to kind of like essentially use propaganda to brainwash people. And he's like, it was my job. It was my job was to convert people to our cause and break people's values about the West and break people's faith in Western values and democracy. And it is interesting because, yeah, he got tortured. He's like, he grew up in a time where, like, you know, people were stabbed with screwdrivers and killed. And he watched his friends die due to racism. Just, you know, people just hate each other based on the color of their skin. And it was just wild. And I think the thing that, like, was so cool about that podcast to me is it humanized radicals. For me, because I really loved this guy. You know, I just he the way he spoke and his compassion, his emotion, his, you know, his rational mind, his ability to think for himself. I feel like he's just become such a good instrument for good in the world. And to see that he was he belonged to a terrorist organization, and he was just too young to do it yet. Like, they caught him and threw him in jail when he was very young. I think when he was 17. So he hadn't actually, like, moved up the ranks to actually do the full-blown terrorism. But he was like, full-on into it. He was ready to do that. And, yeah, Amnesty International. And he said just the compassion of the West, the very people that he thought were evil, came to his rescue and saved his life. And he's like, I converted, you know, right there, you know? And the reason why I bring this up in this video is, like, you know, you know, we're just seeing all these horrific things that happen to good people. And I feel like a lot of the time people say, oh, you know, look at those evil people that took off that person's tongue or raped that person or did that horrible thing. And those are horrific things. Those are horrible. You know, I don't even know how I would describe it if, like, my child one day had that happen to them. But at the same time, like I alluded to with this podcast, I know people can change. And I don't know how prevalent true evil is. I think it's very rare. I think 1% maybe is, like, psychopathic. But I think most people are just, they're brainwashed through ideologies, through religion, through dogma, through even anything can be dogmatic. Science can be a dogma. Religion can be a dogma. Any ideology can be a dogma. Anytime someone says, don't question this, don't think for yourself, listen to us, that's ideology. And I've seen how ideology can just take ordinary people like myself. And I'm sure if I didn't have my mother, and I'm sure if I grew up in a different time with different parents who didn't love me and who didn't, you know, teach me good things, I would likely be able to do some horrific things. I really think so. I know my tendencies. I have a really pure side of me. I have a very empathetic, compassionate side of me, but also I have a survival instinct. I've been an asshole. I've done, I don't know if I'd say terrible things, but I've done things I'm not proud of. I've done, you know what? I've done terrible things. And so, you know, if someone groomed me and, you know, put me through all this propaganda and brainwashed me, I'm sure I could do terrible things too, and way more prevalent, and not actually have too much remorse for it. And that's why I think while we have to look out for victims, I think we also can't give up on people that do, like, it's such a weird thing to say. And I know a lot of people are like, oh, that's despicable. But I'm like, I don't know, like, we're all human beings. I think everybody deserves a second chance. Like, if you have the capacity for empathy and love, I think everybody deserves a second chance. Because what if it was you? What if it was me? What if it was someone we loved that grew up in those circumstances and became a monster? I know there's good in me, and I know I could become a monster. So I wish somebody, if I did something horrendous and grew up in the wrong way, I wish someone would have my back and believe that there's some good in me. Like this, like Amnesty International with this man. You know, I think you can change people with love. I think you can change people because that's why people do this. They don't think people love them. They don't think people can actually look out for them. People can be selfless. And I think that's what we have to show the world. I think that's what we have to do to actually help the world, is show compassion for the people that we don't want to show compassion for. Show compassion for the people that are despicable. And some of them will change and some of them won't. But I think it's worth a try for the ones that could change. Yeah, that's what I believe. And, you know, things always shift. Maybe I won't believe this. Maybe I'll think this was naive in a year or two, and I'll think that people don't change. I'm not sure, but I know some people have changed, and I won't lose hope for that. But yeah, so now moving on. What other songs should we check out by 10 years? Leave a comment down below. And if we don't get any other Patreon requests for 10 years, I'll be looking at you guys to choose the next song. So let me know your favorite songs down below. And if you guys enjoyed this video or anything I talked about, I have a podcast linked down below. And if you want to help me out with the YouTube algorithm, definitely leave a like, leave a comment, and subscribe if you're digging all the content. And also, I want to give a big shout out to my tier 3 patrons over on the Patreon. So we got Brianna, David, Gage, Kelly, Sharon, Russ, and Mark. So thank you guys very much. I love you guys, and I'll see all of you guys again tomorrow. I love all of you. Peace.